So good evening one and all. Welcome to Pantech e-learning. Okay, so today we are going to see about TensorFlow for deep learning application. Okay, so this is one of the most popular one, and then most efficiency one. Okay, so compared to any other deep learning packages, why? Because we have a lot of deep learning packages, but this one is somewhat different, high. It will be give some result with a high process, and then it will be give the result most efficiently, and then most of the persons are really using this TensorFlow package only for deep learning type of applications. Okay, so before we go into this session, I like to give thanks to Saint Xavier's Catholic College of Engineering, and this program is organized by Department of Computer Science and Technology. Okay, so in association with Pantech e-learning, so today we are going to see about TensorFlow for deep learning application. I like to give special thanks to Department of Computer Science and Technology, and then faculty members and respected HODs, and then principals. Okay, so before we go into this session, I like to introduce myself. I am Kamalesh from Pantech e-learning, and here we are going to see about the topic of TensorFlow for deep learning application. Okay, so it mostly it's a necessary topic only in this situation, not in this situation, in this 2020 century. Why? Because most of the persons are willing to learn machine learning or deep learning, and deep learning with TensorFlow and Keras. Okay, so like that, they are, most of the persons are concentrating for their studies, right? So this will be definitely useful for you for improving your skills. Okay, so let me enter into the session. The session is all about TensorFlow for deep learning application. So here we have a table of contents, that is which we are going to see in this whole tutorial. Okay, so introduction, then architecture, and then how to download and install the TensorFlow. Okay, how to download and install the TensorFlow, and then about notebook, and then simple TensorFlow examples. Okay, so this is what we are going to cover in this webinar. Okay, so first we enter into the topic of introduction. Okay, so introduction, I hope most of the persons, if you are familiar, means the introduction is same thing only about Google TensorFlow. So Google is nothing but TensorFlow is nothing but is developed by Google only. Okay, so the most famous deep learning library in this world is TensorFlow only, but we have some other library files also, like we have PyTorch. Okay, and we have different type of FastAI, or like that, we have some other different type of packages we have in deep learning. But most of the persons will be use this Keras with TensorFlow or TensorFlow package for deep learning. Okay, so first of all, you need to know what is TensorFlow, right? So TensorFlow is nothing but it's a multi-dimensional matrix. Generally, we know about matrix, right? So it's a multi-dimensional matrix or multi-dimensional vector, in that we will have some information about your input data. Okay, so that is TensorFlow. So it's a Google product only. Okay, so its main users of why the Google is invented this deep learning type of library package means, actually if it comes to before deep learning comes, if we have machine learning, right? So machine learning have some problem. What is the problem? Main problem of machine learning means, if you are giving an product to improve, that is, if you are giving an n more amount of data, the machine learning predictions will be not good. Okay, so that's what we invent. The Google invented that and deep learning TensorFlow package. So using those package, we can build the TensorFlow, deep learning type of algorithm. Okay, but here they are telling we can the Google will be used for search engines, translation, image captioning, and recommendation. Okay, so if you see the search engine, if you are most of the person, definitely within a day, definitely they will use the Google search engine. So Google search engine will be work under based upon our this TensorFlow only. Okay, so if you are searching for something, it will be automatically give suggest. For example, if you are searching for simple project, okay, so simple and project means we will get an suggest like Java project or Python project or any other domain like blockchain project. So like that we will get an some output. Okay, so like this type of suggest will be comes under based upon the TensorFlow only. Okay, so this TensorFlow is one of the important for search engine. And then translation. Okay, so translation is nothing but we already know about translation, Google translation. So if you are clicking some words, for example, if you are typing some words, you need to convert your native language means within seconds it will be convert and give it to you. Okay, so that is in the uses of this only. Okay, image translation or image captioning or recommendation. Okay, so recommendation system is mostly using nowadays, because based upon the recommendation system only the private companies are selling the product to us. Okay, one of the important things this one. Okay, then like we will move on. History of TensorFlow. Okay, so history of TensorFlow is like a couple of year ago the deep learning is started to outperform all other machine learning algorithms. Okay, so why I have already discussed, we discussed because of massive amount of data. So if you have a massive amount of data, the machine learning algorithm will be outperformed. Okay, so it's not showing an a correct input, sorry, correct prediction result. So if you are having a massive amount of data, so that's why we are going for TensorFlow. Okay, so the Google introduces a TensorFlow package and then we are working on it. Okay, so that is the use of history of TensorFlow. And then Google saw it could see the deep neural network to improve the services like Gmail, Photos, and then Google search engines. So they are implemented for like Gmail, Photos, and Google search engines. About this we discussed, right? And this is the way we can discuss, we can implement our TensorFlow in by Google. And then it is the first the Google is introduced the TensorFlow package in 2015. And then but it is public, and then while first stable version will be appeared on 2017 only. Okay, so till now after 2015 we are not getting correct stable version. After 2017 only we are getting a stable version, and it's a open source for anyone. Okay, so it's under an Apache open source license. It's a open source, we can modify, you can create your own functions and you can implement within that. It's okay, and you can build that anything. Okay, so that is the use of history of TensorFlow. And then we will discuss about TensorFlow architecture, because if you take if you are discussing any type of domains, that architecture is important, right? So we will discuss about TensorFlow architecture. So TensorFlow architecture works on three parts. One is pre-processing the data and building the model and training the estimator model. Okay, so building the model, training the model, and building estimator model. So this is the three steps we are doing with simple architectures. Why means pre-processing data and then build the model and train and estimate model, only three means. Before that we will use some other API frameworks. Okay, so TensorFlow, if you want directly you can use, but it's a difficult one. Okay, so for the difficulties they introduced the Keras. Okay, so Keras is a package used to build an n number of neural networks, like deep neural network or artificial neural network. After building and those neurons, and we will enter those neurons, we will connect through the those neurons, building neurons through the TensorFlow for pre-processing purpose and to build the model and train the model and estimate the model. Okay, so generally they will call as a tensors. Okay, so it's called as a TensorFlow, but generally they were called as a multi-dimensional array called as tensors. Okay, so based upon the tensors we will work on it. Okay, and here TensorFlow architecture, so we already discussed about tensors, but how it will be construct means by a sort of flowchart operation. Okay, so flowchart operation means we will first build the input neurons and hidden neurons and output neurons, and we will pass the input. Okay, so this is the one flow. Okay, first we will be build the flow of your algorithm. Okay, so after you build the flow of your algorithm, then you will be give the input data. Okay, you will be give the input data. After you will give the input data, input will be goes from one end to another end, that is input layer to output layer. Okay, between this we have hidden layer. It will be input, your input will be go one end to another end, and then after you are getting from the another end, that is called as a your output. Okay, so this is the TensorFlow architecture, and then here we can run our TensorFlow with two types. Okay, so we can run using hardware or software, but if you are we have totally two types. Okay, we can use it for development phase, or we can use it for, if you I forgot to tell about hardware and software means it's nothing but we can train and use our model in GPU, that is graphical process unit, or CPU. Okay, so using these two, GPU and CPU, you can install either in CPU way, CPU type of TensorFlow, or GPU type of TensorFlow, and you can run the your TensorFlow package. Okay, so the TensorFlow mostly worked for two phases. One is development phases, another one is run phase or inference phase. Okay, so development phases is nothing but like this is the when you can train the model. Okay, so when you can train the model, the training is usually done by the desktop or laptop. Okay, so this is called as a development phase. Okay, so development phase is just training the model and seeing the output. But if you go with the run phase or inference phase, okay, so once you train the model, okay, those model will be run in different platforms. Okay, that is after you are training the model, you will dump the model as a local file, then you can use that file for your desktop or cloud or any other mobile device. Okay, so this is the two way we can use your TensorFlow. And then introduction to components of TensorFlow. Okay, so if you take a TensorFlow, we got only two things. One is tensor and another one is graph. Okay, so what is tensor means? Tensor is nothing but it's a computational process. Okay, so if you are giving a data like any picture or any CSV file, any data, it will be convert your data into an like n number of vectors or n number of dimensional, okay, matrix dimensional, okay. So based upon that only it will be trained the data, okay. So the all values in the tensor will hold identically a data type with one with their known shape, okay. So with the known shape only we are, and for example if you are training an one image means we need to give the shape of the image, okay. If it is a 32x32 megapixel or like 64x64 megapixel, like that we need to check the image size, sorry, see the image shape, and then you need to give the shape of the image to train the tensors, okay. Then graph. So this is another way you can, is another one components. So using graph way you can gather some information, okay. So it's a advantage of using graph is we can done to run the multiple CPU or GPU, even mobile operating system also, okay. And then we can, graph can save and executed for future, that is you can save your model, if you are run by graph type of procedure means you can save your model and you can execute for further future, and then computation of the graph is done by connecting the tensor to other, okay. So this is the introduction to components of TensorFlow. And why TensorFlow is popular? Why? Because the TensorFlow, why it's a popular means it's the best library for all the aspects, okay. So all the aspects means if we can learn easily and we can access those library files, it's a open source, we can whoever can download the packages, okay. So like that we can do. And then TensorFlow library, it's a incorporates different API, that is we can use either CNN or RNN or any other like LSTM by LSTM, okay. So like that we can use different type of library packages and we can check the outputs, okay. And we can visualize easily using some other neural network with tensor board, okay. And you can install both CPU way and GPU way, okay. So if your laptop or PC with low end type of CPU means you can install it in graphical processing unit, okay. So like that we can do some about this, okay. And another thing, TensorFlow is mostly famous by an GitHub only, okay. So most of the GitHub user using TensorFlow framework only for deep learning framework, most of the GitHub users develop the project with TensorFlow only. So it's a popular one, okay. So this is the way of popular one. And then list of problems, that is list of algorithms supported by TensorFlow, okay. So the current version of the TensorFlow is 1.15, okay. And we have a different type of algorithm like linear regression, classification, deep learning classification, deep learning wipe data, and then we have booster tree regression and then booster tree classification, okay. So these are some of the TensorFlow packages, okay. So we are using, and then I already told you tensor, right. So using paint I will show you how the tensor will be represent, okay. Using paint I will show you how the tensor will be represent. So for example, we already know TensorFlow is a collection of future vector, okay. Otherwise it's a array of n dimensional, right. So for example, if you have a 2x3 matrix, if you have a 2x3 matrix, that is we have the 2x3 matrix consisting of values 1 to 6, values from 1 to 6 means we can write this 2x2 matrix like this, right. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and 6, okay. So this is the way we can represent our 2×3 matrix generally. Okay, but the TensorFlow in represent of this 2×2 matrix, 2×3 matrix is different way. How means? Like this. Like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3. This is first one. Then after that, 4, 5, 6. The second one. Okay, then it will be concluded with another one square bracket. So this is the way we can the TensorFlow will be represent this 2×3 matrix in this way only. Okay, so generally we already know about this, right? How we can draw, we will, that is n dimensional. Okay, so this one we know, right? It will be stored based upon this manner only. Okay, so it will be stored based upon this manner only. How means? Like in front, this is the front side and then this is the back side, right? So in front side we have a data of 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and in back side we have a data of 5, 6, 7, and then 8. Okay, so that's why I already told you it represent, that is TensorFlow will represent in a matrix that is in n dimension. Okay, so in n dimension, so it represent will be like they, like this way only. Okay, so this is what this is in matrix, but if you want this is matrix means this. So that is we have like different types of tensors also, we have like unique label or dimensional or data types. That is unique label is they are generally called as a name, and then dimensional means they can generally called as a shape of the input, and then data type means generally called as a data types. Okay, and like this we can use our TensorFlow packages in different manner. Okay, but this is apart from this. Now we comes to know what is the use of TensorFlow and how it's working, who invented, and then for simple example how it's working and all we seen, right? But till now we didn't seen how you can use the TensorFlow in your PC, right? So we will see now how we can use the TensorFlow package in our PC. Okay, so if you want to use your TensorFlow without online, that is we have totally two type we have. One is online based on, with online we can work your Keras and TensorFlow package with online. Otherwise you can work with offline also. If you want to go with offline, you need to install this Anaconda Navigator software. Okay, so it's my suggest. If you wanna use some other IDE also, it's not a problem. Okay, so you need to use Anaconda Navigator to install your package in your PC. Okay, so how we can install means, we can install after your installing the Anaconda Navigator, you can go to the environment. In this environment you have a base root. Base root is nothing but this is, if you are installing any Anaconda Navigator, you will be have default root, base root, that is default version of your Python. Okay, so I installed Python 3.7 Anaconda Navigator. So now it's come for more plus 3. Also you can check it out using Anaconda Navigator organization, that is respected website. And we have, you can create a new environment also using Anaconda Navigator. Okay, so using this create option you can create a new universe. So here you can see I created a new environment only. Okay, in this environment only I installed my packages, Keras and TensorFlow packages, but I will show you in base root also how you can install TensorFlow and packages. Okay, you can install in your local disk in two ways. One of the way is you can select this all. Okay, normally they will be in the installed. You need to select all. After selecting all, you just type using tensor. TensorFlow. So you have an option to install the TensorFlow. Okay, and here you can see TensorFlow GPU. Okay, so we can install the TensorFlow package of GPU. And if you wanna use like TensorFlow as a GPU, means we need to install TensorFlow as a Keras as a GPU. Okay, so then only we can build our neural network algorithm and we can check it out the outputs. Okay, so this is the way you can install the TensorFlow packages. Otherwise, if you are installing only Keras in your PC, automatically it will be installed backend as a TensorFlow. Okay, so here you can see backend as a TensorFlow we can automatically install. Okay, so this is the one way you can install your package in your PC. Otherwise, we have another one way. If you are clicking this button, it will be asking like this: open terminal, open with Python, open with IPython, and open with Jupyter Notebook. You can use open terminal. Here you can run the command pip install TensorFlow. Okay, so now I am not installing, but I will tell you how to install the package. Okay, so after using this pip space install space TensorFlow, you can click and if you click an enter button, automatically the package will be installed from online. So this is the another way you can install in your PC. Okay, so now we done with two way how we can install the packages in your PC by using Anora Navigator. Okay, this is the offline method, but I already told you we have online also. So online is very easy, but every time we need an internet connection for using that, that's it. That is one of the disadvantage, but we can easily use online. How means, here I will show you. So here I opened my Google web search engine. Here I am typing on Google Colab. Okay, so after I am searching a Google Colab, it will be give in next page like this options. You just click and again Google Colab. So it will be enter into your like this. Okay, enter into the page Welcome Collaboratory. Okay, so it will be enter into the page in this page. Here you can create your new file. The new file is nothing but new notebook. Okay, so new notebook, or you can open your old notebook. Okay, so this is not a problem. Okay, so I already done some codes using the okay, so this is here you can write a code and then you can check the output of your input data. Okay, so this is called notebook. Okay, generally they will run the code line by line. First you can type the code and then you can run using this icon, then after you can type the code, then run using this icon. Okay, so it's not like a Java or C++ code. You need to compile all the code and you check the output. You can run the output line by line and you can check the errors. Okay, so this is the way you can run your Google Colab file. But same thing, same notebook, that is same extension. The notebook extension is IPYNB, Interactive Python Notebook. The same extension will be available in our Jupiter also. Okay, so that is in Anagola Navigator we have a one web-based interactive notebook file. If you click this launch button, it will be enter into your file browser. Okay, so that is default web browser, and then it will be open like this only. What we are having the interaction, same interaction will be available in Jupyter Notebook also. Okay, so the name is different, but the extension of the file creating is same only. Okay, so for example, here you can see I am running my notebook in local disk. How it's working, we'll see. So here I am launching the Jupyter Notebook. After launching the Jupyter Notebook, I enter into a Microsoft Edge. Okay, so in Microsoft Edge, it's showing like this package. So here you can run your code. Okay, you can create your new Python 3 file. After you are creating a Python new Python 3 file, this extension of Python also untitled IPMB file, and then the Google Colab which I created the new notebook file also untitled IPMB file. Okay, so we can run this even in Jupyter Notebook also, it's not a problem. Okay, so this is the way you can use your IDLE. Okay, so if it is an Jupyter Notebook, you need to install the package. If it is a non Jupyter Notebook, you don't need to install the package also. Okay, so it will be inbuiltly available. You just need to import a package, is that's enough. Okay, so for example, I am typing the code of importing an package. Okay, so just wait a minute, it's connecting to the runtime to enable the file browsing. Okay, so first of all we need to wait for some few more minutes, then it will be start to connect the run the code. Okay, so I'm importing an print function. Okay, so I'm importing an print function. After importing a print function, what is the main name? I need to import an TensorFlow. So about this we discussed everything in few minutes before. Now we can work on with TensorFlow how it's doing. Okay, so if you want to import a TensorFlow package, you need to use like this. Okay, so in Google Colab, if you are wanna suggest, means you can use control space, it will be automatically give some suggest. Here you can use, you can import your respected package. For example, I need TensorFlow package, so here I will check for TensorFlow and then as TF. Okay, so this is the way you can import your TensorFlow package in the TF. Okay, using TF. Okay, so TF is nothing but the TensorFlow package will be saved as a TF. Whenever we need TensorFlow, we need to work on use this TF only. Okay, so now for example, I am printing the hello TensorFlow using hello variable. Okay, I am calling the TensorFlow TF dot constant. Okay, so TF dot constant, I am not getting any suggestions. Why? Because here we need to run the shell, so that is the notebook file. If you are running this particular file, then you are going to the next line of the code, means you will be get an error. Why? Because if you are entering any code in this shell, you need to run line by line. Okay, that is important. So here I am importing a TensorFlow. After importing a TensorFlow, you need to use this one, that is TF dot constant. So now I am checking for suggest, so I am getting a lot of suggestion. Here I need to use constant. Okay, and then my main aim is I need to just print a statement. Here I am using Hello. Then I am using TensorFlow. TensorFlow, but here I soon I given a close. Here I am using like this TensorFlow. Okay, so like this I am giving, then I am closing the function. Okay, so now what we done, just a simple code only, just a hello printing an hello statement using TensorFlow. Okay, so here I am using a constant. Okay, so definitely you will be get an some doubt what is that constant. Okay, so nothing but in TensorFlow we got some different type of operators. Okay, so operators is all about like I will create a new cell, otherwise here I am typing. Like we have operators like involve the manipulation of tensors. Okay, so the four main tensor you can create, the four main tensors by using TF. TF dot one is variable. Okay, so one is variable and another one is TF dot constant and another one is TF dot placeholder and then the last one TF dot sparse tensor. Okay, so these are the four operation we can do with TensorFlow. Okay, so variable, constant, placeholder and sparse tensor. So here I am using a TF dot constant. Okay, so now you will be comes to know what is the use of constant. Okay, so here I am using a constant. Okay, so now what I will do means, after using this constant I am just giving some string values. So these string values I need to print. Okay, so creating a new code line, here I am passing the session. Okay, so if you want to print means we need a session function. Okay, so here I am passing a session, that is I am creating a new variable. In this new variable I am giving TF dot session. I am not getting session function. Yes, TensorFlow has no attribute session, otherwise I will check it for small s. For small s also I am not getting. Okay, TF dot, everything is perfect, only TF dot session. Okay, otherwise we just print the statement. Hello is not defined. Okay, now we need to run this cell. After if we are running means it's printing hello TensorFlow by Pantech e-learning. Okay, so the shape is null and TensorFlow data type is string type. Like this we can do with this hello. Okay, so we can print like this also, and we have some other operations also. Okay, so like what are the, we already discussed about now, like variable, constant, placeholder and then sparse tensor. Like that we have some other functions also, you can try with that functions. Okay, what are the use of constant and what is the use of variable. Constant we seen now is for string type, okay. So if it is a variable, what, and then you can check it out, okay. So like this way you can build your TensorFlow packages. But sometimes if you are using an like Jupyter notebook file, sometimes you will be not get an like module, not you will be get a module found error, okay. If you are getting a module found error, definitely you will be not have TensorFlow. So if you want to install directly using Jupyter notebook, you need to use command like this, pip space install space. This one, this is the command. I am not telling for particularly TensorFlow. If you wanna use for like any other pandas or numpy or matplotlib, anything, you need to use these things, okay. So this is important, so that's why I am showing you, okay. So pip install TensorFlow. But one thing, for example, if you want to, everything is done using TensorFlow, if you want to build on neural network algorithm, means it's a difficult, we need to do lot of codes, to type lot of codes, okay. So instead of that, we are using as a Keras, okay. So Keras is the package, okay. So Keras is the package to build an neural network algorithm, okay. So using Keras, you can build your architecture, that is graph of your layers, okay, input layer or hidden layer or output layer. Then after that, you can connect with your for pre-processing and then for training and then for evaluation purpose, you can use the TensorFlow as a backend, okay. So generally, if you are importing in Keras packages also, automatically you will be get a notification of TensorFlow working on backend, okay. So that is the uses of Keras, okay. So for example, if you wanna build Keras packages also, I will show you now how we can use Keras package, okay. So here I am creating a new one. Here I am importing an from Keras, okay. From Keras, you need to import like convolution CNN, convolution neural network. That is, CNN is nothing but convolution neural network. So convolution is nothing but it's a layers, okay. So the layer will be available in Keras only, okay. So Keras dot layers, and then I will import the package of convolution, okay. I will import the package of convolutional, and then I will train the, I will pass the input data of the convolution, okay. So if you are study this convolution, sorry, this we need to use here, you can see we have convolution of 1D, 2D and 3D. Mostly we will work on with 2D only, like if you take a normal image, we have 2D type image, right? We have n number of pixel values. The pixel values is nothing but the range of color value, that is numbers of color values, the combination of blue, red, green, we have a number values. So using that number values, we can train the algorithm, okay. So that is the use of convolution 2D. If you are using convolution 2D, definitely we need to use pooling method, okay. That is, we need to reduce the size of the pixel value. So here I am using the maximum pooling 2D. Why? Because I imported an convolution 2D only, so we need to use maximum pooling 2D, okay. So this is the way you can import your layers from the Keras, okay. You can easily build your layers using Keras, and then after you can pass your data to the TensorFlow, and then TensorFlow will be pre-process those data and then evaluate the data, train the data, and we can test the data. Okay, so this is the way you can build your layers. Okay, so generally this is the way you can work on with Keras and TensorFlow. And we already done, I already posted, that is I already in live I do some work with Keras and TensorFlow, like detecting an animal images or pictures or simple neural network, how we can build, already I done. If you are free means you can watch it in our channel, you can go and check it out, the lot of videos will be there. And if you are new to this channel, you can please subscribe the channel, definitely you will be get an knowledge about Keras, sorry, not only Keras, machine learning, deep learning, OpenCV, IoT, and then trending technologies, okay, like blockchain, like Android application development or Java programming language, everything we have. So please subscribe and hit a bell icon if you are new to this channel. Okay, so that's it about TensorFlow working. If you have any other doubt, you may ask it in our comment section, I will reply you, okay, how it's working and all. If you have any doubt, you can ask it, ask in our comment session, I will reply you. And I send today's session attendance link, you can register for you that using that attendance link, you can register. Attendance will be available up to 7 p.m. only. So if you want to register, this is, you can register. And if you fill that form, definitely you will be get a e-certificate. So register it, and then any other doubt you may ask it in our comment section, I will few more minutes, I will give some clarify your doubts. Till now I didn't try about TensorFlow while getting an installed remove scipy. Till now I am not getting any error about, like, regarding this. I don't know about that queries. Google Colab use local hardware or cloud? Google Colab is fully cloud only. We are not using any local hardware. If you are trouble, if your PC configuration is too low, you can better using Google Colab and you can build your deep learning projects. And we have another one session on 7 p.m. today. Now after this webinar, we have another one live session at 7 p.m. And if you need, means you can contact. The session topic is all about just wait a minute, I will tell you the session topic. If you want to contact me, you can contact on hyd.java@pantechmail.com. Sir, to install TensorFlow, we have to select only TensorFlow and Keras. No, if you are using with Anagoda Navigator installation, you just first install a Keras package. So automatically Keras will be installed TensorFlow as a backend. Okay, so if you are using Anagoda Navigator, don't install TensorFlow. Just install Keras, automatically TensorFlow will be run with backend. Okay, so today 7 p.m. session is all about Arduino. Okay, so who are all not familiar with those topic, you can check it out.
No, no, no. That's why you don't need to install TensorFlow. First of all, you install Keras. Okay. After installing a Keras, automatically you can install your package. And if you are like this video, please hit a like button. And if you are getting some knowledge, means you can share this video to your friends. They will also know about you. About this, how we can develop a deep learning type of projects on TensorFlow. And about today's attendance link, we have in description and then in comment box also. So please check it out and register for it. We already I taken a webinar on how we can deploy a machine learning model. So you can just refer our YouTube channel. It's available. Deepak Haridas. The site cannot be reached, sir. Certificate. Yes, that's it. I hope everybody will understood about the today's topic, TensorFlow for deep learning application by the College of St. Xavier's Catholic College of Engineering. And I like to give some other information. So the information is all about IIT technical training program August 20. So start from August itself. So now also it's available. If you want to register, you can register. Totally 5 days, each day 2 hours. And for ISF students 300 and non-ISF student 350. So if you want to register, I will show you the contact numbers. You can contact that person. They will help you. And then we have a IIT intensive program for 15 days. So we have lot of department and domains available. You can check it out. And then if you want to register, you can register for 1600 IIT members and for 1715 non-IIT members. And if you want to contact, like if you want this webinar, like this webinar for your college or for you, or if you want a internship or any other training program, you can contact to those numbers, Mr. Sendil Kumar, Mr. Srinivasan and Mr. Kumaraswamy. They will help you regarding internship registration and webinar topic confirmation. Okay. And if you have any doubt, you may contact me on hori.java@pantechmail.com. And if you need furthermore upcoming events or furthermore information you need, you can contact us on WhatsApp and Telegram channel also. Okay. So thank you all. I hope everybody will understood about the deep learning concept using TensorFlow. We will see you on any other nice video. Up to this, it's signing off from Kamalesh. Bye.